Right now, as you're watching this, over 290 million people worldwide are living with a virus that many don't even know they have. It's called the silent epidemic, because it can hide in your body for decades without symptoms, all while quietly damaging your liver. I'm talking about hepatitis B, and here's the scary part. You could have it right now and not even know it. But here's the good news. It's completely preventable, and if caught early, it's manageable. In the next few minutes, I'm going to break down everything you need to know about this hidden threat. What it is, how it spreads, the warning signs your body might be sending you, and most importantly, how to protect yourself and your loved ones. Because when it comes to hepatitis B, what you don't know really can hurt you. All right, let's get started. So first off, what exactly is hepatitis B? Hepatitis B, or HBV, is a viral infection that primarily attacks the liver. The word hepatitis literally means inflammation of the liver, and in this case, the inflammation is caused by the hepatitis B virus. Now here's what makes hepatitis B tricky. It can be either acute or chronic. Acute hepatitis B is a short-term illness, usually lasting less than 6 months. The immune system fights it off, and most people recover fully. But if the virus sticks around for more than 6 months, that's chronic hepatitis B, and that can lead to long-term liver damage, cirrhosis, or even liver cancer. And here's the scary part. Many people with chronic hep B don't even know they have it, until serious damage has already happened. So how does hepatitis B spread? HBV is transmitted through blood and body fluids. So you can get it from unprotected sex with an infected person, sharing needles or drug equipment, from mother to baby during childbirth, blood transfusions, though this is rare now with modern screening, sharing razors, toothbrushes, or anything that can carry blood. It's not spread through casual contact like hugging, sharing food, or coughing. So there's no need to isolate or avoid people with hep B. All right, let's talk about the signs and symptoms. Now, here's the thing. Many people with acute hepatitis B have no symptoms at all. But when symptoms do show up, they usually appear within 1 to 4 months after exposure, and they can include fatigue, nausea, or vomiting, abdominal pain, especially in the upper right side where the liver sits, loss of appetite, dark urine, pale stools, joint pain, and the big one, jaundice. That's when your skin and the whites of your eyes turn yellow due to high levels of bilirubin. In chronic hep B, symptoms might not show up for years, but over time, liver damage can lead to persistent fatigue, swelling in the abdomen or legs, easy bruising or bleeding, confusion if liver failure starts to set in. Now let's pause here for a sec. If you're finding this video helpful, go ahead and give it a like. And hey, if you know someone who might need to hear this, share the video with them. You can even drop it in a WhatsApp group. Trust me, someone in your circle might be silently dealing with this and not even know it. All right, so how is hepatitis B diagnosed? How is hepatitis B? Doctors use blood tests to detect HBsAg. That's the hepatitis B surface antigen. If this is positive, the person is infected. Anti-HBs. This shows immunity, either from recovery or vaccination. Anti-HBc shows past or current infection. HBV DNA. This measures the viral load, how much virus is actually in the blood. And liver function tests, LFTs. These check for liver inflammation or damage. Doctors might also do imaging like an ultrasound or even a liver biopsy in more serious cases to assess for scarring or cirrhosis. Okay, let's get into treatment. For acute hepatitis B, most people don't need medication. The immune system usually clears the virus on its own. Treatment is supportive. Rest, hydration, and avoiding liver-damaging substances like alcohol or unnecessary medications. But for chronic hepatitis B, the goal is to suppress the virus, prevent progression to cirrhosis or liver cancer, and reduce the risk of transmission to others. Treatment options include antiviral medications, like tenofovir or entecavir. These help keep the virus under control and reduce liver inflammation. In some cases, interferon injections might be used, especially in younger patients or those who want a finite course of treatment. Regular monitoring, even if someone isn't on meds, they need regular liver function tests, imaging, and checkups to watch for signs of liver damage or cancer. Also, and this is big, vaccination is available and super effective. The hepatitis B vaccine is part of the childhood immunization schedule in many countries, and adults at risk, like healthcare workers or people with multiple sexual partners, should get it too. And just to be clear, chronic hep B can't be cured. But with proper management, many people live long, healthy lives. Now let's do a quick recap, and then I'll hit you with some exam tips and mnemonics. So, hepatitis B is a viral liver infection spread through blood and body fluids. It can be acute or chronic. Symptoms range from fatigue and jaundice to no symptoms at all. Diagnosis is done with blood tests like HBsAg and HBV DNA. Treatment involves antivirals, monitoring, and, in the best case scenario, prevention through vaccination. All right, now for the students. Here's a mnemonic to help remember hepatitis B serology. Sick, shielded, or silent. HBsAg equals sick. The person is actively infected. Anti-HBs equals shielded. The person has immunity from recovery or vaccine. Anti-HBc IgM equals silent recent infection. The person recently caught it. Anti-HBc IgG equals silent old infection. Person had it in the past. Also, remember this for exams. Hepatitis B equals DNA virus. Important because most hepatitis viruses are RNA. Chronic HBV increases risk of hepatocellular carcinoma, even without cirrhosis. Vaccine is recombinant. No live virus acute HBV in adults. 90% recover, but 90% of infected infants become chronic. And for liver function tests, elevated ALT and AST, especially if ALT greater than AST, usually points to viral hepatitis. All right, that's it for this one. Whether you're a med student studying for boards or just someone who wanted to understand this virus better, I hope you found this helpful. If you did, give it a like, hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to share it with someone. Even drop it in your family WhatsApp group. You never know who might need this info. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.